everybody, it's your girl Issa Joy back with another video. I know I've been like MIA for a few months and I promise there is more content coming, but I thought I would switch things up and give you all a travel vlog. So this week I'm headed to Austin, Texas for South by Southwest EDU, and I figured why not bring everyone with me. I'm calling this video Operation Go to Texas and Not Catch COVID. I'm using, I should say, all of my Monos luggage. So I'm using like my carry-on and the duffel. I am going to check in my carry-on this time, and that is because since I'm going to be gone for about 4 days and I have a lot of different things that I'm trying to do and like I just want to be prepared, I have a lot of liquids with me basically, and I did not want to be confined to the 3-1-1 rule. So that's why I'm checking my bag. But the carry-on does fit into the overhead of pretty much every major airline. I'm flying Delta, and so it would fit into the overhead. I know a lot of people have asked me, and previously I haven't flown since using the luggage, but I just wanted to clarify that in case anyone was like, oh, did it fit in the overhead? And like, get skeptical about like why I didn't use it. I am going to link in the description box a couple of other people who have actually flown and put their carry-on Pro Plus in the overhead, just so that if you actually wanted to see it and like get some type of confirmation and assurance that it's going to fit on the airlines that you travel, you can check those videos out. So hopefully you all can hear me with my mask on. I don't know, we shall see. I'm obviously wearing the N95s that the feds sent out or like to all the pharmacies across the country. And it is tight. I made it through security and I stopped at Starbucks. I got a banana bread. I'm not really hungry, honestly. I feel a little nervous, I don't know why, so I don't have much of an appetite. But I also don't want to like go all day and not eat and get a headache. So I got the banana bread just in case I get a little hungry on the plane. The vanilla sweet cream cold brew from Starbucks is amazing. If you're like me and you like coffee, but you don't like it to be like super strong, you like a little sweetness to it, it's like perfect. But yeah, not much has honestly changed. I know maybe it's because we're not in the thick of the pandemic, but...
I know.
Whoa, whoa.
Yeah. It's easy. As you make it.
So, I don't know if y'all can hear me, but I just got off the plane.
Attention to
terminal. I definitely feel like I am. I don't know, I just feel like I'm void of oxygen. But I'm on my way to baggage claim.
Y'all new music, don't ask me how I feel about it. Don't got problems being real, I got real problems. Old school top down slide in the Phil Collins.
I'm in Austin! I checked into my hotel, I guess maybe like a little over an hour ago. I can't remember. But yeah, I did not get a chance to actually film getting here because it was a little stressful actually getting into the hotel. And I also did not want my phone to die, because for some reason it just really started going out. So I didn't actually get to film like coming here, but the hotel is amazing. It is beautiful. I highly recommend. Like, customer service is top notch. I know that like I'm here with like a whole bunch of other people, and so they're probably like showing out for everyone, but like honestly, it is a really, really nice so far. And I have like, trust me, like as someone who stayed in a lot of hotels, like literally from like 2-star to 4-star, not saying I've ever stayed at the Four Seasons, but I have stayed at some nice, like legit nice hotels. And this definitely ranks high on my list. So yeah, if you're in Austin, I think it's worth the splurge. I am gonna go down for sure and get something to eat. I think today might just be like a chill day. So we shall.
My Phil Jackson, and somehow he blessed me with Uncle Phil Wallet. But my other Uncle Sam in my pockets, like I'm feeling dropping. I'm blessed though, he only taking it because I got it. Look, if I peel out, I squeeze. I hype and go beast. You boys is hype beast. You boys light, I move at light speed. So rooted hurricane to me's a light breeze. Watch me fuck TV, but the way I channel. Yeah, more like a conduit. Plus it's going gold if I ever put palms to it. And I did my whole career in napalm fluid. See, we the ones that blowed up, y'all niggas blew it. Bet on me to never fail, it never fails, that's how we do it. You don't have the right to hate on me unless you took your mama out of hell. Then in the hills, then move it to it. And the way I dealt with love.
Good morning, Austin. This has to be like one of the dreariest days God ever put together. We'll be spending a full day at South by Southwest EDU. Yeah, so let's put this face on. Okay, so I am on my way to get brunch with a friend. We are like a block away from 6th Street. So we're obviously already downtown, but you can kind of tell we're headed towards like some of the bigger buildings that is in Austin. All these scooters are everywhere in Austin. Some pretty cool murals too. Right before I got to the restaurant, it started raining, so I will definitely be riding back to the convention center if it's still doing this later.
Is by helping people never get on welfare to begin with, and education. I mean, that's where I landed from a professional perspective, and because of my lived experience, along with my professional experience, I feel like I have a clear sense of what's actually needed at this point in order to help education actually become that great equalizer.
All right, so that obviously tees us up towards, well, then what is there a collective goal, or what is the collective goal that we should have?
And the ways that it impacts us every single day. Education determines who gets access to jobs in the future, and it's front of minds of people in the news, all of us as educators, as students, and as parents.
So here today from four different perspectives, two students and two scholars, we want to approach the systemic challenges to getting to, staying in, and succeeding after higher education.
All right, so we're outside the convention center, day one, successfully complete. I'm on my way to UT Austin to meet up with a couple of my students. They're gonna show me Longhorn life and grab me some dinner.
When a good girl gone bad, what you gonna do?
I am beat, y'all. I am beat. I had a fantastic day. As you can see, like, the sessions went really well. I got to see UT Austin, got to meet my students. It was fantastic. I logged like 14,000 steps. My heels hurt, and I have like really comfortable shoes on, so like my feet don't hurt, but like I think it was the standing and like the pounding of my feet on the pavement. Maybe I was walking too hard. The pads of my heels hurt so bad. So I hope you enjoyed however much of day one that you saw, and we will wake up in the morning and do it all. We're not going to do all of this again. We're going to have a less exciting day tomorrow, but still a great one. Still a great one. It is day 2/3, depends on how you're counting it, basically it's Wednesday. Let's get into this lighting, y'all.
I feel like a model. What?
So I'm on my way to get breakfast. This is just a solo breakfast date this time. There's this little place called Forthright that someone told me about. So I'm going to check it out before my first session. But yeah, first I think we're gonna take
it. It's like I get consumed by girls who never satisfied with everything I'm doing. It's like once I give them space, they gonna want the moon. Shit, I'm already a star, what more can I do? The world pick me, must have good taste and be picky. I'm that nigga for real, I don't know what it's like for girls to not want me. Only know what it's like when they miss me. You either believe it or not, it's not Ripley's. Late night studio sessions, our stomachs were touched.
We couldn't really focus on our studies. There was no motivation to do it. I mean, we obviously did. We tried to keep our spirits up. We'd all have little Zoom meetings with our friends to you got this. But it was very hard for us.
And John Mark, you had a similar experience. I mean, you finished high school and started college. I mean, what was that process like for you?
Yeah, it was weird because I was sort of in a transitioning period because I was doing dual credit at the time, and it was a transition between graduating high school and starting into college. And so I was sort of getting used to college while finishing out my years of high school during the middle of a pandemic.
How are you doing, man?
Nice to see you.
Hey everybody, so I just got out of the session with Secretary Cardona, who's amazing. He's amazing. He's awesome. I was trying to get my selfie with him, but it was really hard. Secret Service was blocking. They whisked him away. but I did get some cool pictures of him. So I'm just sitting, not sitting, I'm standing outside. It's a beautiful day, but it's breezy. So I just came out here to get some video and some photos. Such a pretty view of the city. And then I'm headed to a meetup for post-secondary education. So day three continues.
No matter how far ahead the click it, we touch back. It's been looking up our whole lives. We'll never have hunchbacks. Leaving everybody where they had me fucked up at. Mountaintop views where the inspiration spews. Sometimes when you
a new friend in Austin.
Cues. Everybody favorites just imitation use. Talking in the mirror more than occasional. Cause that's the only one who gon' relate to you. Cause you the one. For real.
Let me show you guys the elevator. So if we say we're going to fitness center or something. Elevator G.
Sorry I cut it off prematurely. I didn't want to be on the elevator. I think I was weird. So it's the last day. I can't believe it. It is March 10th. It is the day. I'm feeling good. I'm feeling good. Alrighty. So we are walking to the convention center. I like to look behind me because there is a lot of sketchy people walking around Austin, even during the daytime. Not a lot, but a little bit. We're heading up the stairs and let's go in.
Next week we'll take you to the show.
do. So I was like, why don't I just go to work? So I'm like, They had COVID testing at South By, but I didn't get that done because I was a little paranoid. I was like, what if I do test positive? Like, I'm not going to be able to get on the plane. Like, I just, you know, like, whatever. So I'm going to do one of these. Hopefully it comes back negative. We are looking for one line. That's our hope. So as you can see, like right here, a negative test is one pinga line and a positive test is two. You have to look really, really closely because sometimes the second positive line is like really, really light. Like it's not always as dense as the control line. But looking at it from all angles, there is nothing there. So that means... booyah, mission accomplished. We made it to Texas and back without catching the Rona. We did it. Thanks for watching.